2018 Lexus ES 300 hours review. The hybrid S prioritizes fuel economy over performance but never forgets that it's a luxury sedan. What happens when consumed by the fuel efficiency provided by a typical hybrid but want more room plus an upscale cabin? A large luxury hybrid, it doesn't cost a fortune, may appear like an impossibility. Nevertheless, the 2018 Lexus ES 300 hours delivers on all fronts. This comfortable cruiser provides spacious transport for approximately 5 passengers, all while returning fuel economy around 40 miles per gallon. You definitely receive a lot of car for the investment with the ES 300 hours. It costs just a little more than the related Toyota Avalon hybrid. However, the Lexus is undeniably the harder luxurious in the two. That doesn't imply the ES 300 hours is perfect. You are doing give up some functionality whenever you upgrade. We're specifically speaking about the Lexus Remote Touch Infotainment Controller, that is for us to work with even for seasoned tech veterans. Overall, though, the 2018 Lexus ES 300 hours should easily satisfy those who desire a fuel-efficient and roomy luxury sedan. What's new? The Lexus ES 300 hours receives no major changes for 2018. There's just one version from the 2018 Lexus ES 300 hours, but several option packages are worth considering. The premium package is inexpensive yet adds appealing luxury touches, say for example a power adjustable leader, driver seat memory settings and wood trim, an absolute upgrade on the standard piano black pieces. It's also required if you would like add the navigation package. We think the luxury package is yet another good buy. It bumps within the price by way of a healthy margin, however its extra security measures and real leather upholstery are worth the cost. Trim levels and features. The 2018 Lexus ES 300 hours luxury sedan includes a 4-cylinder hybrid powertrain, and can achieve better fuel economy than its V6 powered ES 350 sibling. It sports in a single, well-equipped trim level, having a number of available feature packages and standalone options. Note that some options and configurations could be limited determined by where the automobile is purchased. The hybrid powertrain features a 4-cylinder engine and electric motor using a combined creation of 200 horsepower. The combo sends capability to the front wheels using a continuously variable automatic transmission CVT. Standard equipment includes 17-inch alloy wheels, LED lighting headlights, taillights, running lights and fog lights, automatic high beams, automatic wipers, a sunroof, heated mirrors, keyless entry and ignition, adaptive cruise control, a forward collision warning system with automatic braking, and lane departure warning and mitigation. Also standard are dual zone automatic climate control, 8-way power front seats with tower power lumbar, simulated leather upholstery, an auto-dimming rear-view mirror, a rear-view camera. Lexus Inform Remote provides for smartphone control over some vehicle functions and Lexus Safety Connect emergency communications. On the infotainment front, the ES 300 hours includes a driver information display, an 8-inch central monitor, Siri eyes-free iPhone voice control integration along with an 8-speaker sound system having a CD player, satellite radio, HD radio as well as a USB port. There are a couple of notable packages designed for the Lexus ES 300 hours, starting while using navigation package. It includes the mouse-like remote touch interface, a navigation system, voice controls, an extra USB port, plus the Inform suite of smartphone-connected apps and concierge services. A 15-speaker Mark Levinson surround sound speakers can be included in this package. The premium package adds an electricity adjustable controls, driver seat memory settings as well as some wood trim choices. The luxury package has the premium package and tax on leather upholstery and heated and ventilated front seats. It also necessitates the addition of varied standalone options, including front and back parking sensors, a tire trimmed in leather and wood, an electric rear sunshade, upgraded headlights, and blind spot monitoring with rear cross-traffic alert. Finally, the ultra-luxury package has everything in the luxury package, including a driver seat cushion extender, passenger seat memory settings, upgraded leather upholstery, manual rear side sunshades and ambient lighting. Trim tested. Each vehicle typically also comes in multiple versions that happen to be fundamentally similar. The S in this particular review use our full test in the 2017 Lexus ES 300 hours 2.5 litres inline 4 hybrid, CVT automatic, FWD. Note, since this test was conducted, the existing S 300 hours has brought only minor revisions. Our findings remain applicable on the 2018 S 300 hours. Driving. The S300 hours is faster in a very straight line than its chief rival, the Lincoln MKZ Hybrid, but neither will be as entertaining to drive an automobile as a performance-oriented plug-in, for example the BMW 330. Handling is for a car such as this, but hair trigger brakes which has a soft, spongy bedding are inexcusable. Acceleration. Acceleration factor is dull inside default driving settings. The eco driving mode only exacerbates this challenge, while sport improves it somewhat with sharper power delivery. The S can accelerate to 60 miles per hour within a respectable 7.8 seconds. Braking. The brakes are initially very grabby. Even if you're familiar while using brakes, smooth stops don't come naturally. We needed 117 feet to avoid from 60 miles per hour, that's average with this class of vehicle. Steering. The steering has lots of assist, though the actual ratio is slower than average. There's also no steering feedback to communicate in of, however the instant feel is enough to hold the S300 hours pointed straight at highway speeds. Handling. Considering this can be a large, soft-riding Lexus using a big power supply, it handles okay. Body roll is well-controlled, setup tires don't provide much grip. It doesn't do also with quick transitions, the automobile is slow to retort. Drivability. The S300 hours usually pulls far away from stops in a very pure F mode. Even so, the engine fires up smoothly and quickly as needed. You can feel once the engine kicks on, but overall the transition is impressively smooth. Comfort. In classic Lexus fashion, the S300 hours exhibits a soft ride quality that diminishes or altogether neutralizes any jitteriness that poorly maintained roads could potentially cause. Performance through the sedan's climate control method is disappointing, though. Seat comfort. All outboard seats are happy over long distances. The rear bench is determined to a gentle recline, though passengers would further take advantage of a seat's bottom having a little more rear tilt. A lack of lateral support is understandable given your vehicle's mission. Ride comfort. The ride is predominantly soft and comfortable. Highway cruise vacations are enjoyable. But the ride can receive a little bouncy while on a trip on undulating roads, plus some mid-corner bumps will be sending the occasional shudder throughout the cabin. Noise and vibration. Road and wind noise within reason quelled. When the electric motor is recharging, it creates a high-pitched whine that some buyers probably won't expect. The gas engine sounds a little overworked whenever you dig in the accelerator for power. Climate control. Dual zone automatic climate control comes standard, and heated and ventilated front seats are added with our tester's luxury package. The ventilation function is weak, as you move the heaters will simply toast rear ends about the highest setting. Heated rear seats aren't available. Interior. Aside from minor problems with getting into and out with the car, the S300 is not difficult to tolerate. Highlights include fantastic outward visibility plus a spacious cabin. One caveat, we haven't tested an example together with the panoramic sunroof, that may affect headroom. Ease of usage. All controls in the top are clearly labeled and within easy reach on the driver. There's even a protracted pad just aft with the mouse controller in order to rest your hand when using the it. Getting back and jetting out. Taller drivers may find it fairly hard to avoid grazing a knee on the tire bottom when getting into, even while using wheel tilted entirely up. Otherwise, entry is simple all the way around. Low seat bottoms inside the back slightly impede exiting. Driving position. The driver's seat supplies a nice array of adjustment and it is a nice destination to sit overall. For longer leg drivers, the base cushion may experience slightly short minus the ultra luxury pack as you move the armrests are just a little low if you want to cruise along with your hands with the 3 and 9 positions for the wheel. Roominess. This big sedan has abundant legroom and shoulder room for those outboard passengers. The standard sunroof doesn't cut into front headroom by any means, though tall rear seat passengers might brush their hair resistant to the roof when fully leaning from the seat back. Visibility. A low belt line, narrow pillars and larger windows with light tint combine to present the driver excellent outward visibility, even with all the seat occur its lowest position. A rear view camera comes standard, back and front parking sensors and blind spot monitoring are optional. Quality. The S displays the solid building we've got to expect from Lexus. Trim pieces line up perfectly, and contrast colored stitching looks good. There's nothing terribly daring or awe-inspiring, but perhaps that's to get the best, for the busy interiors we've seen in other Lexuses these days. Utility. The S300HS cargo area dwarfs rivals by a few cubic feet, but because of battery power placement, you simply can't fold the back seats right down to increase it. Adding child seats is simple thanks to a large back seat and easily accessible latch anchors. Small item storage. There's some cup holders back and front, and leading door pockets will each accept a H2O bottle laid on its side. There are no rear door pockets or additional trays in top. Cargo space. The cargo area measures 12.1 cubic feet, that's larger than you will find in rival hybrid sedans. However, while using battery compartment pressed contrary to the bulkhead, there isn't any pass-through and you cannot fold the spine seats down. Child safety seat accommodation. There are two latch anchors that jump out from each from the outboard seats. They are accessible, both aero unsightly considering they may not be hidden by any means. Three tethers within the rear shelf are concealed and similarly simple to find and hook to. Technology. All the newest safety systems are here, however the S300 stumbles on other tech fronts. You need to download Lexus app to possess access to items like Pandora. Along with the infotainment system's mouse-like controller will continue to fall short in user-friendliness. Audio and navigation. The Lexus infotainment system's mouse controller is an intuitive and fast to control. Give it a thorough test run for the dealership, and that means you know you'll be able to live with it. The Mark Levinson system sounds good but lacks a bit strength to totally satisfy our audio demands. Smartphone integration. You must download Lexus Inform app suite to work with smartphone apps, for instance Pandora and Yelp with the central computer screen. Inform remote lets users perform basic functions, for example door unlocking and cabin air conditioning, from their phone. Apple CarPlay and Android Auto are notably absent. Driver aids. The S300R comes standard with several advanced safety systems, including lane departure alert and pre-collision warning with automatic emergency braking. The last an example may be especially important. It also comes in handy given how difficult it's to effectively make use of the brakes. Voice control. Lexus voice command prompts you to definitely communicate with pre-selected phrases, but we found detection of natural speech being limited. Siri Eyes Free is theoretically provided by connected phones, but I was unable to have it to work on our test car. Yeah.